Well, thank you so much for having me here. It's an honor to be here amongst such amazing and inspiring speakers. I would like to start today with one word. The word is mumukshatva. I'll repeat it. It's mumukshatva. It's a Sanskrit word. And what does it mean? It means the intense desire to break free from temporal limitations. In other words, it means the desire to become limitless. You know, all of us at every point of time in life have this desire to become limitless. Some of us want to become limitless through spirituality, some of us through devotion, and some of us through work. Today I'd like to talk about becoming limitless through work. We've grown up with these sayings, you know, work is worship. In English, that's what we say. The Japanese call it ikigai. The French call it raison d'être. Whatever the name we give to it, the idea is that if you love what you do, you are going to be happy, healthy, and always, always content in life. And that's the truth. You know, we've heard the saying, aaram haram hai. And now research proves it, because they've said that people who retire, they die faster than people who continue to do what they love. And of course, all of us are on a different journey in life. Some of us discover what we love early. Some of us discover what we love late in life. But that's not the point. The point is that the discovery should always happen. In my case, I was lucky. I was very lucky because it was at the age of 4 that I realized that I love to sing and I love to entertain. So by the time I was 9, I was already learning music. I would go to school in the morning and I'd be performing as a child artist, doing stage shows in the evening. And by the time I was 13, 14, I'd finished some 100 stage shows as a singer across the country. So I've been working literally all my life. And in fact, I was in my 7th month of pregnancy while I was working, and I started working like 3 months after delivery. So for me, whatever life situation I have been in, I have constantly, you know, been working. And now I realize that not only do I love acting and singing, but I also love producing. And I've just produced a web series in Gujarati, which will be out soon with Malhar Thakur. The point being that show business, of course, some of us are a part of show business, and show business is like this amazing yummy cake that everybody wants a bite of, but very few people have the stomach to actually digest it. And whether you're an actor, you're a director, you're a cinematographer, you're an editor, writer, any creative field, show business is tough. I'm sure Karan and I'm sure Pooja, they understand how tough it is, because it pushes you, you know, to the edge of despair. There are huge highs and then there are lows. There are days when the whole world loves you, and then there are months when nobody really cares about you. And then there are days when you're working all the time and then suddenly there's no work. So you are going through these huge waves of up and down and, you know, despair and sadness and euphoria. So literally show business is like pushing you to the corner of, to the lengths of whatever you can really take. And as a woman in this industry, I have of course faced a lot of judgment myself. When it comes to women, and especially women actors, we are always defined by how we look and what our bodies are. And I was told I'm too thin to be an actress. I was told I'm not pretty enough to be an actress. I was told, oh my God, Mansi, if you get married, your career is going to end. Well, I've been married 12 years and I've had a 12-year successful career, so I don't know about that. Then I was told, Mansi, bacha hoga khatam. Ab to I don't think kuch hoga. But I mean, I debuted in my Bollywood film, like Udi is out in the theaters. I have been doing, you know, ads, I've been producing. So I literally think, you know, times have changed and one cannot define or judge anybody according to their gender, of course. And also, I think work and life are very connected for me. I believe my work is an extension of my life, and I think work is an extension of most of our lives. We spend more time with our colleagues than we do with family members. So it's very important for us to kind of, you know, put in the effort in the right way and to actually really do what we really believe in, because only then would life be meaningful. And of course, a lot of people ask me how I managed to, you know, be a mother, be a wife, be an actor and all of that. I think women anyway are great at multitasking. But there are some tips that I definitely like to share. The first tip that I want to share is that I think one should be the best at what they want to do. Because in this day and age, there is so much competition that if you're not good at what you do, there are thousands of people as good or better who are ready to take you over. So one has to constantly upgrade, constantly revamp, and constantly keep, you know, chiseling away and making sure that you're really good at what you do. The second that I would say is that always ask for help. As a mother, I think I'm right here talking while my two-year-old is in Bombay and my family is taking care of her. It's not easy, but I know I can't do it alone, so I'm always ready to ask people for help and say, you know what, I can't do it on my own, I need your help. So I think another thing that we need to learn in life is to definitely ask for help. It doesn't make you weak, it just makes you smart. The third thing I would say is invest in the right life partner. I mean, I cannot stress enough how important it is to have the correct life partner to be with you. It's almost like if you choose the right life partner, it's the best career move that you've made. My husband is so supportive and that's why I can do whatever I can do. You need somebody who's responsible. You need somebody who understands your ambition, who understands your goals, and who supports you through the thick and thin. Because without that, it all goes downhill. The fourth and most important thing that I believe in is hustling. You know, in Gujarati, any Gujaratis here? Obviously, I'm coming to Ahmedabad and asking any Gujaratis here. Ha! I was just being funny. But no, so Gujarati, there is a kahavat, ek kahavat hai, ki je bole na bor vechai. What does it mean? It means that the one who screams the loudest gets his goods sold. So I think in this day and age with social media, one really has to be out there and talk about your work and talk about what makes you, because only then will people know who you are. And you know, actors are out of work a lot, okay, let me tell you this. Because we depend on so many external factors. We have to depend on the casting director casting us and thinking, okay, we're good enough for the role. Then the director maybe making a role that we could fit in, and the whole project finally taking off. So there are so many stages and levels to this job which are really not in our control. And I remember when I was studying at the Lee Strasberg Theatre and Film Institute in New York, the first thing they told us was that if you think that you're good enough, and if you have the ability to create work for yourself as an actor, then you should do it. And that's what I did. You know, I mean, you can't wait for people to cast you. You can't wait for people to create an opportunity for you. So I wanted to work in a Gujarati web series. Being a Gujarati, I've loved Gujarati theater. I love the language, and I thought I should do a web series. I've been working in the Hindi language since 12 years, but nobody was making a web series in Gujarati. So I thought, why not I make a web series in Gujarati? So I produced this web series, and I conveniently cast myself in it, obviously. So I made this web series. 6 episodes have been shot last month, and it's going to be coming out soon. It's called Do Not Disturb. You should check it out. You'll be getting to know more about it. But the point is that you cannot wait for people. And I'm being a Gujarati, we all have that andar se thoda keeda that nahi yaar, kuch karna hai. So, you know, a lot of my friends tell me, yaar, tu to itni gujju hai. Because, you know, I mean, they don't get it. I mean, a lot of us have that business and that entrepreneurial spirit anyway within us. And I have it too. And I said, why should I define myself as just an actor or just a singer? I want to do whatever I can in my life. So, yeah, hustling is a part of the game, and hustle is what makes you work. And, you know, the sixth point that I'd like to talk about is staying relevant. It's interesting, I was speaking to another actress friend of mine, her name is Shruti Seth, and she said something so good. She said, you know, this is the only profession for a woman where the older you get and the more experienced you get, the lesser work you get. Because literally in every other profession in the world, the older you get, the more experienced you get more money and more work. But it's not true here, because youth is of prime importance. So how does one stay relevant in an industry where everything relies on youth? Well, one stays relevant by doing various other things and by making sure that you're not just stuck onto one thing, and that's what, you know, I do. And so basically I'd like to sum this up by saying that all of us have a different ikigai, we have a different mumukshatva, but at the end of the day, what all of us are looking at is some kind of a meaning in life. And if we end up doing things that are meaningful to us, then our lives become more valuable, they become more blissful and more happy. And as Thomas Jefferson says, the harder I work, the luckier I get. So that's all I'd like to say today. I hope you find your ikigai and your passion for life and continue to stick onto it. And I hope it brings happiness and love to all of y'all. Thank you.